immediately impressed me as a very imposing and impressive figure. Loads of flatulent humor and gentleness. I think he spoke to me for about 5 minutes. He said, okay, you're in. And I was hoping Father would be here, but thank you, Father, because that really did change my life. So I joined in sixth grade, and sitting right next to me, as right now, was your president, Gopal Vengeri. And that also, as you can see, has changed my life. So Gopal's been a good friend, of course, in my days here, which were a long time ago. And then I went to the States and lost touch with just about everybody in Bangalore. It was only, I think, about 7 or 8 years ago that there was a group of Josephites who came to New Haven and New York that I suddenly got in contact with people I hadn't met in 20 plus years. Gopal was one of them. And since then, I've come to Bangalore many times, and Gopal has always been incredibly efficient in organizing a group of friends to get together. And it's really meant a lot to me to reconnect after all these years with an incredible group of students I was lucky enough to be in a long time ago. So what else do I remember of my days? I remember some exceptional teachers. There was Mr. Yates, affectionately known as Papa Yates, very kindly math teacher. I guess math was one of the subjects that I picked up very quickly, but he nevertheless kept me interested and also kept me out of trouble, because I was often ended up making a lot of noise in math class, and I remember him, be quiet. There was Mr. Luke D'Souza, a very strict but excellent teacher. I remember Mr. Coutinho. I guess he's still around, right?
Yeah.
Yes, Coutinho, sorry. I don't remember what subject he taught us, but civics, yeah, okay. But mostly he told us wonderful stories about his life. And I remember he told this incredible story about smoking cigarettes and how it destroyed your lungs and how is it possible to give up smoking. And really, because of that, I've never smoked a cigarette in my life. So that was also a very good lesson from one of my teachers. So after leaving Joseph's, as you heard, I ended up at MIT. And really, as I talked in my address yesterday, while I was at Joseph's, I knew I was getting an excellent education. But I still felt that perhaps it wasn't what people in America and England were learning. They were learning stuff that we couldn't dream of. But, our system was, looking back, extremely well designed. Sciences and mathematics at a young age, and the same subject is taught over and over again, so that by the time they get to high school, 11th standard, 12th standard, many basic concepts have become second nature, and you don't even think about them as something you learn. They seem kind of obvious. And that, I think, was an excellent way of teaching the sciences, and I see the difference with my own daughters who have gone to school in the United States. Of course, there are many wonderful things about American schools, but, for example, they don't learn the basics of chemistry until 10th or 11th standard, and like many things in life, it's almost too late for them. So anyway, that kind of preparation really stood me in good stead when I got to MIT. I found that I could really compete easily with the best in the world, and I owe that really to the education I got here at Joseph's and the not just the facts and figures, but just the way of learning and dedication to education and enjoying what we're doing. Okay, so I think that was what I had written down, even though I haven't read it. Again, I'm just overwhelmed with this incredible honor. Oh yeah, one more thing I was going to say. That was the first thing. So Gopal called me 2 or 3 weeks ago. Actually, he messaged me on Facebook, so excellent on social media and said, you know, would I want to come here? And my immediate reaction was, I was just so moved, of course, I'm going to come, I'm going to make the time in my schedule and somehow get here. But my wife was very skeptical. She said, you know, you're 50 plus, I won't say how much older, you can't take this trip, you know, your back's hurting, no way. So then I talked to my dad, and he said immediately, of course you should go. But that's where he became the person